Kennedy, let's switch the focus to Zambia quickly. What's the position now with you? Can you tell us exactly, are you continuing with your international career or have you put a full stop behind it?
Listen, they just asked me that question again. I think it was today. Look, for me, I think there was a lot of things which was going on with the national team. And for me, I think when they left me behind for these two games they played with Zimbabwe and Algeria, I think for me, I was still busy doing my goalkeeping coach courses. So I think it worked to my advantage because I was busy with it. Reason being why they left me, I don't know. I don't have any idea. But you have to respect the coach, what he wants. So for me, I think I didn't have a problem. It gave me time to look at some other things. So yeah, for me, I think look, there will be always football politics, especially when you come, we talk of African football. There is a lot of football politics. So for me, I think I don't want to engage myself in all those things. No. But for me, when they asked me the same question, am I still available for the national team? For me, I told them, say, we'll see, I have to make a decision. But at the moment, I'm a bit busy. I'm a bit busy. I even told them to say, there's a lot of youngsters who are coming to fold. And I've been with the national team since 2004. I've been up and down with Sundowns now, up and down in African national team. The league year is waiting. I haven't had time for my family. But at the end of the day, I think when the country calls, look, I cannot say I won't play completely for the national team, but there's things they need to fix. The association, they need to fix a lot of things. So for me, I think at the moment, no, I'm not really. I don't, I'm not part of the national team at the moment. No, they have to fix their. They must fix their things first.
When you do look back on your international career, that 2012 Africa Cup of Nations win obviously stands out like a beacon, a massive achievement. I mean this with the greatest respect, but I think it's fair to say that Zambia were not among the favorites going into those finals. So what was it about that team and those few weeks that really things clicked for you?
Look, I think if you look at that team, I think there was only one or two were European based. The rest they were playing in Africa. And when you look at that team, compared to the other team, that team we had respect for each other. We were like a family. We used to know they knew my weaknesses. I knew my defenders' weaknesses. We were like a family, and it never took only 2 years. It took about 3 years or 4 years to build all those things. And for us, we went to the tournament knowing to say we are going there because we are underdogs. Because at the end of the day, all the teams we played with, we were the team which featured a lot of players from Africa, from TP Mazembe, from Zambia, from South Africa. You can mention from Egypt when most of them they were there. So we were the only team which had a lot of players playing their trade in Africa. And for us, I think it was an advantage for us because we used to spend a lot of time together. And plus, Evrena knew about each and every one of us. And he knew because he knew how to treat Zambian players. And like I said, the respect was there. There was no egos in camp. We knew you are playing for TP Mazembe. When you come national team, we forget about TP Mazembe. We forget about Free State Stars. We forget about you are playing for Germany, for a team in Germany. We forget about everything. We are now playing for our national team. We are playing for our country, not a club. So that is the thing which really helped us. And then we were pushing towards the same direction. There was no one who thought I'm bigger than this one or I'm lesser than this one. All of us were like a solid team because of F also. He came with all those things. He spoke a lot, not about tactics, but the togetherness and to fight for one another.
Kennedy, last question to you. They say if you take a bottle of red wine and you leave it for a good 20, 30 years, it gets better and better and better. When are we going to see the end of your red wine? How many more years with your skills?
To be honest, it's true when they say to say the goalkeeper, the more you become old, the more you become even more wiser. I think for me, I think it's about the love of the game. Sometimes, you must listen to your body. When the body says, I'm tired, you're tired. I can be 36, but the way I'm feeling at the moment, I think I can push for another 3 years. So yeah, another 3 years. I told someone just now, I said, I cannot stop playing now when a striker who's 40 years old is the top scorer in Zambia, James Chamanga, I'll never stop playing football now.